Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Wednesday, Memorial of St. Andrew Kim, Tae-gŏn and Companions. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. The blood of the holy martyrs was poured out for Christ upon the earth. Therefore, they have gathered everlasting rewards.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who have been pleased to increase your adopted children in all the world, and who made the blood of the martyrs, St. Andrew Kim Tae-gŏn and his companions, a most fruitful seed of Christians, grant that you may be defended by their help, and profit always from their example. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am writing you, although I hope to visit you soon. But if I should be delayed, you should know how to behave in the household of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar and foundation of truth. Undeniably great is the mystery of devotion, who was manifested in the flesh, vindicated in the spirit, seen by angels, proclaimed to the Gentiles, believed in throughout the world, taken up in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How great are the works of the Lord.
How great are the works of the Lord.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
How great are the works of the Lord.
Majesty and glory are his work, and his justice endures forever. He has won renown for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord.
How great are the works of the Lord.
He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant. He has made known to his people the power of his works, giving them the inheritance of the nations.
How great are the works of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "To what shall I compare the people of this generation? What are they like? They are like children who sit in the marketplace and call to one another. We played the flute for you, but you did not dance. We sang a dirge, but you did not weep. For John the Baptist came neither eating food nor drinking wine, and you said, 'He is possessed by a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and you said, 'Look, he is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' But wisdom is vindicated by all her children." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today we have a gospel that I think is really a critique of the Lord. Now we'd like to look at it as the Lord's critique of the religious, not just practices of that time, but of the attitude, no, of the practice of religion. No? So first you have the Lord talking about the demands of our, what are the requirements or the demands of our faith. No? So that's the first point that we will look at. No, and then second is that I think related to that first point, what the Lord is criticizing is that how people have made faith convenient for them. No, it was really more according to what was convenient for them. No, that's the second point to reflect on. And then the third is that very powerful last statement of the gospel. but wisdom is vindicated by all her children. No? So first about the demands or requirements of our faith. No? As the Lord said, no, we sent you John the Baptist, and you said who was fasting and was really a hermit, very, very, and very much like a monk, no. And then they said he was possessed by a demon, no. So and then after that, Christ comes, no? and thus in quotation marks the opposite, no. And then they criticize him for drinking with tax collectors, drunkards, the outcasts of society, no. So here you see now, what the Lord is saying now, I think, no, when you take a look at this, is that, you know, there's a certain amount of conversion needed, no, when we hear the messengers of God. John the Baptist, remember, had a very clear message, no, preparing the way of the coming of the Messiah. That's why it was a call to conversion, no, a call to conversion that started with the confession of our sins. And really, no, as we say in Filipino, yung pagbabalik loob, no, it was a very, very, very deeply spiritual and almost ascetical conversion, no. And when Christ came, no, it was now a call to conversion. But remember, now he was also introducing the joy of our faith, no. And in fact, remember that Christ was saying, no, that how can the wedding guests be sad, no, if while the bridegroom is still with them? They must celebrate while the bridegroom is them. The day will come, no, that you will need to sacrifice, no. So here, I think at the end of the day, for me, it is always that call to conversion. And remember what we reflected on several days back, that the call to conversion is to listen to the message of Christ, to listen and to act and to obey. So that requires, listening requires conversion. If we are to act based on what we have heard, it requires conversion. And this brings us to the second point, no? That what happened was that the people had made it a religion of convenience. Whatever they wanted to do, they adjusted, no? They adjusted what they heard. And therefore they were just doing what they wanted to do, no? So that is the second point that I invite you to reflect on, no? Because in the end, for me, that is really our great sin, even to this day, I think, no. Remember what we always reflected in the past, no? Reflected on in the past, wherein that what our novice masters were telling us, no? Do you seek consolation or do you seek the God of consolation? Because there lies the problem here, no? That when we make religion and prayer life according to our own needs and we adjust it to our needs purely, no? So we seek the consolation and we do not seek God, no? So maybe that second point to reflect on, no? And then the third and final point is that the Lord simply ends by saying, but wisdom is vindicated by all her children. Perhaps another way of looking at this is that the Lord is saying, by the fruits you shall know them. And I think now he makes reference to all the holy men and women who come after this proclamation of the gospel. The martyrs, for example, no? The martyrs that we celebrate today, Saint Andrew and companions, no? They are the fruits of those who have received the message of Christ and those who have acted on it, those who have dedicated their lives, offering their very lives itself, no? Wisdom is vindicated by her children. The men and women who have dedicated their lives to the message of Christ, to the good news of salvation. Siguro napakahalaga na pagnilaya natin to, no? Sapagkat makikita din natin dito, masusuri natin ano ba ang estado ng ating pananampalataya. Kagaya ba tayo ng mga pinapansin ng Panginoon, ano, yung mga taong hindi talaga nagbabalik loob, ano? Kasi nga, di ba, yung mensahe ni San Juan Bautista, yung mensahe ng Panginoon, ay merong panawagan sa pagbabalik loob, ano? Pero ang nangyayari, hindi sila nagbabalik loob kasi mahalaga na pag nakinig tayo sa mensahe, di ba, pinagnilaya natin ito, kailangan makinig at isabuhay. At doon natin makikita yung tunay na pagbabalik loob na hindi ginawa ng mga tao kasi lagi nilang pinipintasan, ano? Yung mensahe ni San Juan Bautista, mag-ayuno, kailangan mag-ayuno, kailangan mag-ayuno. Sabi nila, hindi, sira ulo yan eh. Ano yan, may sa demonyo, no? Kasi nga, weird, no? Tapos pagdating naman ng Panginoon na pinuproklama ang kagalakan ng ating pananampalataya, anong sabi nila? Ay, wala yung ginawa kundi makipag-inuman, kumain, sumama sa mga makasalanan. So doon makikita no, na hindi nakikinig sa mensahe at lahat lang ay pinayaan nilang ayon lamang sa kanilang gustong makita. At ito yung pangalawang punto, no? Ito yung pangalawang punto na ang nangyari, ang relihiyon ay ginawa nilang kasangkapan kung ano yung kanilang kagustuhan. Sabi nga natin, di ba, sa mga nakaraan natin pagninilay, hinahanap ba natin ang konsolasyon o ang Diyos na nagbibigay ng konsolasyon? Kasi ganun yung nangyayari. Hinahanap lang nila kung anong gusto nilang maramdaman. Hindi nila hinahanap ang Diyos at ang kagustuhan ng Diyos. Yun yung pintas ng Panginoon. Ano? At yung pangatlo at huling punto, sabi ng Panginoon, ang wisdom ay vindicated by her children. No? Yung wisyo ay magpapatunay, no? Na yung kanyang sinasabi ay siyang mensahe ng Diyos. At ang kanyang tinutukoy dito, di ba? Sabi niya, di ba, sa bunga ng tao, doon mo makikita kung ano talaga siya, kung anong pagkatao niya, kung saan siya nanggaling. At siguro tinutukoy ng Panginoon dito ang magiging ehemplo, no, ng mga banal na mga lalaki at ng babae ng simbahan, kagaya ng mga martir natin ngayong araw, no. Sila yung anak ng wisdom, no, na magbibigay ng patunay na tama ang sinabi, tama ang mensahe, no. Siguro mahalaga na pagnilayan natin asaan tayo, no, sa ganitong klaseng masasabi, temptasyon to eh, para sa ating lahat, no. At nakasangkapanin natin ang relihiyon, ang ating pananampalataya. Pero mahalaga sana ay tunay nating maunawaan, ano, kung ano ba ang hinihingi sa atin ng ating pananampalataya upang tayo ay tunay na makapakinig at sana ay kumilos ayon sa mensahe ng Panginoon. The coming of our Redeemer was foretold by the prophets by preaching repentance for sins. John the Baptist heralded his coming in the spirit of penance. Let us ask God's help through our prayers.
That the church on earth may continue to thrive and draw more faithful to the feast of the kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the rich and the poor alike may not make excuses to evade the call of the kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may respond to the call for repentance with sincerity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor, Almighty God, on the offerings of your people, and through the intercession of the blessed martyrs, grant that we ourselves may become a sacrifice acceptable to you. For the salvation of all the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised, for their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the hosts of angels cry out and without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Andrew and companions, the martyrs, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly serve and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes all, so Filipinos may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Nourish with the food of the valiant as we celebrate the blessed martyrs. We humbly ask you, O Lord, that clinging faithfully to Christ, we may labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. Thank you for joining us. Thank you.
Paglipas ng panahon, kumusta na ang ating kalikasan? dahil sa climate change, paglaho ng iba't ibang uri ng hayop at halaman, plastic pollution, coal mining, oil spill. Tunay na madilim ang ating hinaharap kung magpapatuloy tayo sa pagsira ng ating mga kabundukan, kalupaan at katubigan.
Alay para sa Kalikasan highlights the importance of ecological protection in securing greener and safer future for every Filipino. Nagsasagawa tayo ng capacity development, advocacy campaigns, at iba't ibang mga proyekto to educate people and push for policies that can protect the environment.
And through Alay sa Kalikasan, Caritas Philippines envisions nurtured natural ecosystems, better law enforcement and policy making, and a healthier nation.
Panapanahon ng pagkakataon, may babalik ba ang kahapon?
Pagkalinga sa kalikasan, ito ang ating alay kapwa.